Guys, this is me, Justin. I'm going to try on NBA 2K18 to recreate LeBron James's first round game winner against the Indiana Pacers on Thaddeus Young. So, I don't know. Is my friend Landon's on here? Oh, thank you. Landon's probably not even on here right now. Okay, guys, I'm just gonna get on NBA 2K18 right now and try to recreate LeBron James's buzzer beater. So bad. Swish. Guys, started watching the Cavs game? Well, the game. Hold on, guys. Okay, the Cavs have the ball right now, and the game is tied at 66.
Check me out right here, yo.
Yo, the sun don't shine forever, but as long as it's here, then we might as well shine together. Better now than never. Business before pleasure, P. Diddy in the back. And who you know do it better. Yeah, right, no matter what, you hear tight. So when you hear songs, make sure you hear it right. Don't make it out of yourself by assuming.
It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
Keep it moving, what are you doing? You know that I'm two levels above you, baby. Call me, baby, I'ma make you love me, baby. Talking crazy ain't gonna get you nothing. And that jealousy is only gonna leave you broke. So the only thing left now is love for these cats.
There is a buzz in the air in the sold-out Brick and Loans Arena. You'll see the Indiana Pacers facing the Cleveland Cavaliers. The excitement of the NBA is on the way.
Guys, I know this video is going to be pretty boring. I'm just mainly just going to be dribbling the ball.
Now, here's James. And a couple of big-time pivots going head-to-head tonight. Doris looking at the NBA right now. How has that center position evolved on both ends of the floor?
Well, it seems to me that increasingly, unless you're a shot maker from the perimeter, you can't find time on an NBA floor. So certainly they've become more perimeter-oriented. The ability to at least make a mid-range jump shot helps the spacing on the floor. And then obviously on the defensive end, Kevin, the more valuable you are is based on can you switch and pick and roll situations, guard a variety of positions, say 3, 4, 5, and if necessary, in an absolute pickle, can you stay with a guard if you've got to switch and pick and roll between a big and a small?
Let's check out Indiana's starting lineup. Collison and Oladipo pair at the 1 and the 2. Young and Turner up front, and it's Bogdanovich in at the 3 spot. That'll be a 5-second call. against LeBron. Inside, Turner with the steal. And out of bounds, the Cavaliers will take it.
Cavaliers ball.
For the Pacers.
About 1 minute into the first quarter. And that one's good by the
guys, I have to at least score a couple points.
Back on that 2015 draft, hard to argue that Turner shouldn't have gone higher.
Yeah, I think it was the unusual running style. There were some concerns that it might predispose him to injury. The Pacers training staff actually found a muscular imbalance, so they helped him strengthen certain areas and correct that issue.
Shout out to my boy Squeakle. This is the guy who made me bring up this video.
If LeBron James is connecting from the outside, the defense is in trouble. Nice stroke from downtown.
And that one drops. Turner's got his first 2 points of the night.
I'll tell you, that's an assist that shows...
At the end of the game, we're going to try to do the buzzer beater. It's going to...
LeBron outside, scoring his third straight basket in three tries.
Doesn't seem to matter. LeBron's in rhythm. Defenders can be draped all over him. It doesn't matter.
Shot's good by Turner.
And that was a real quick comeback there. Both sides showing some range.
Well, both teams are pulling the trigger right now, showing great confidence from behind that arc.
Here's Korver. Yes, and it's LeBron picking up the assist.
And where's the help? Obviously, a missed rotation. Something they're going to want to patch up.
Right, because otherwise you're going to give up those close range opportunities all night. If you allow the opposition to get into a groove, look out. Boy, nice stroke from downtown. Got it off just before the defense could react. That's his specialty.
First quarter of ball, almost 2.5 minutes in. Trying to answer back, but that three is off the mark. Pacers have gone 4 of 5 from the field so far. Turner. Chance there to take the lead. Missing. Cleveland's gone 3 of 4 on three-pointers in the first quarter. Doing well from long range.
At one, guys, we're 3 seconds. I'm going to call for timeout.
LeBron. Timeout is called. First of the game for the Cavaliers.
Yeah, just hitting a reset button.
So, guys, now let me turn the controller off. Hey guys, let's turn this controller off.
I think sometimes that's all it takes, right?
Okay. Let's try to recreate LeBron James's buzzer beater. Get it? Yeah! But that wasn't for the win, though. That was the wrong player, guys.
Did he get the basket off in time?
He did.
And the footage relayed to the officials from the replay center in Secaucus, I think he got it off in time. The replay leaving little doubt.
It is a shot.
Now they're going to switch the call. There is no doubt, looking at the replay, that he got it off in time.
Guys, Love got it off in time.
Nothing rattles him. Nothing throws him off his game.
up to this point, a closely contested game as we start the second quarter. And taking a look at the Cavaliers' performance here, what do you guys see?
Listen, early on taking the league, I just like their approach offensively.
I think their play calling has been exceptional. They played with purpose, and they played with aggression.
I need to tie the game up.
And chance here presented by Gatorade to see who's on the floor, all fueled up and ready to go for the start of the second quarter. And so in the game for the Pacers. Sabonis and Turner, the young big man up front. Corey Joseph is out there with Victor Oladipo. And it's Bogdanovich in at the small forward. Doris, every team now is looking for bigs who can rebound, block shots, defend in the perimeter, and hit the face-up jump shot, which we've seen. But now they're moving outside. That's asking a lot of the versatility from that one position. So when you think of that, who fits the bill in your mind?
Well, the guy who was eye-popping in limited action was Mr. Joel Embiid. What a great personality and a diverse skill set on the offensive end. Anthony Davis and Carl Anthony Towns, both from the University of Kentucky, have the kind of skill set that I think makes them the prototypical next-generation NBA player. Those guys can step away, make three-point opportunities. Both can face up, put it on the deck, and go in either direction. Both can go with their back to the basket. I mean, what a luxury for those coaches to have a big man with those capabilities.
No, not right now. In a minute, yes.
A superstar, a playmaker, a coach on the floor. Some say he's the GM. And he even has a stake in a player agent business. LeBron says it's his dream to one day own an NBA team. Well, he's certainly getting some practice. Kevin?
No question about it, David. He's well on his way. As important a player as we've ever seen in basketball.
You know, without a lot of shot blocking on the interior, the Cavs play a very conservative defensive style. A low rate of steals, they want to stay in front and prevent penetration.
And Oladipo kicks to Sabonis. Time to shoot. There's the three. Cavaliers with the rebound. And for the Cavs, some defensive regression from a top 10 defense in 2016, Doris, to a bottom 10 last year.
Yeah, it's hard to dispute the notion that their offense carried them. Now, some would attribute that to coasting in the regular season, but still, their aim was to win it all, and tough to do that if you don't defend at a high level.
Looking at who's out there now for the Cavaliers. Larry Nance has checked in for Green. Smith comes in for Hood, and it's Calderon in for Clarkson.
Just an example of what sets LeBron apart from everyone else. The ability to set up his teammates for easy scores while being so dominant himself.
And Doris, coming into the NBA, Love's game was centered around the basket, a double-double machine.
Well, think about this, Kev. One of five players in the last 3 decades to average over 15 rebounds for an entire season. He did that in 2011, and he still remains a factor on the boards because he's got terrific understanding of positioning and great lower body strength.
The Pacers making a switch here. Stevenson's checked in. Let's it go from the wing. Oladipo, good. Oladipo's got 5 points in the quarter.
And sometimes there's no defense good enough for Victor Oladipo, an incredible shooter even with a hand in his face.
And out of bounds as the Pacers gain possession. Tristan Thompson is checked in for Kevin Love.
Tristan Thompson.
Here in the second quarter, we've played a little over 2.5 minutes now. Oladipo outside. There's 14 seconds left in the first half. Doubled by Smith. Clock at six. Oladipo with the ball. Timeout call, Cleveland. In addition to going over the game plan and making whatever necessary adjustments have to be made.
Guys, LeBron James has 6 seconds to shoot the ball off. Okay, guys, so,
without proper hydration, a player can completely run out of gas down the stretch of a game. And that's something that none of these guys can afford to have happen. If you're going to back all the way to the finish, you have got to be hydrated.
officials signaling they are going to review the tape.
Yeah, that's a tough call there with the naked eye. Fortunately, the league's replay center able to slow it down, zoom in, and check all the angles.
Guys, that might not be good.
And it looks like they got it right this time. No basket. The clock had expired while the ball was still in his hand.
And even if they don't show it, I know the refs are proud of themselves after the replay sees it right. They're like, see, we had it right all along. So, good call, fellas.
And the first half comes to a close in a tie game. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Here with Coach Deron Liu. Coach, what is the focus going to be in the second half?
Just play the right way. Move the ball, share the ball, get stops if you got to run the transition.
Always leads to good results. Thanks, Deron. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David, for that interview. And we'll see you back here after the break for third quarter basketball. It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, everybody. Along with Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal, I'm Ernie Johnson. Time for the NBA Halftime Show on 2K Sports. LeBron James had it going on in the first quarter. He had 9 points, 2 assists, and 1 rebound. Kenny, your thoughts. How are the Cavaliers playing?
So far, I love their commitment on the glass. Even when they were playing well, their rebounding remained a priority. So far, the other side hasn't matched their efforts.
Shaq, your take on Indiana.
Well, they had a hard time scoring inside. In fact, their offense was run almost exclusively along the perimeter. A lot of jumpers. It's too predictable. You got to mix it up.
Guys, let's try to create this buzzer.
And we're just about ready for the start.
We're probably gonna keep the score at 20-20, guys.
Cleveland, Ohio, home of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Why tonight to that recently is worth the price of admission. We have a post-ball game on our hands as we get set for the second half of basketball. Look at LeBron James. He's really been playing well.
His points.
Doris, you went from the basketball court right to the broadcasting booth. Having seen the game now from an analyst perspective, what... why you go back and tell Doris the player?
Yeah, I'd probably tell myself to throw myself completely into the vibe of the team. To never, even if I were struggling as a basketball player, to turn inward. I would always say turn outward to your teammates and invest in what's going on as with the group. And then that seems to make everything fall into place.
And mentally, too, I think you've got to turn focus like you were as a player when you are going.
No question about it.
At the four, it's LeBron with Love at the Five. A lethal front court pair. Smith is out there with Hill, and it's Korver in at the three slot. That's the five for Cleveland right now. Oladipo for three. Korver with the defensive effort.
I'm kidding, guys. I'm gonna keep the score at 23.
From beyond the arc in this game. Up against Turner. Love outside. There's the pick, and there's the feed to Hill. Just 5 to shoot. That's in there. Love with the assist. And now it's a 3-point Cavalier lead.
I think it takes a lot to throw George Hill off his game. He is so masterful, so under control, even with a defender in his grill. You know, it's interesting. Kevin Love was 2 different players, right, guys? I mean, a losing offensive rebounder with a battle inside, but also a skilled perimeter shooter.
That's it. Yeah. Okay, guys, hold on.
Let's hope.
Okay.
Why are you told to do that 3 times and he was getting ready to do it?
In a couple minutes, Mom, I'll be down with your phone.
Oladipo, that you must respect his 3 ability. When he's locked in, the defense has to contest.
Hill passes to Love, tries it from the top of the key, and again, it's 3-1.
Guys, I want the game to be tied.
Part of Kevin Love's game.
Well, I think it's certainly something he's added since coming to the NBA. From barely shooting any early on in his career where he was a flat back-to-the-basket scorer, now three-pointers account for almost half of his field goal attempts.
Not watching the line there. That'll be a backcourt violation.
You know, you've got to be composed mentally right now at this time of the game. It's really careless play right there.
And Cleveland making a change here. Clarkson's checked in. Indiana also making some changes. Sabonis, he's checked in for Miles Turner. Booker comes in for Young. And it's Joseph in for Darren Collins.
Game's tied, guys.
We know Oladipo is one of the quickest guys in the game. He is devastating on the drive.
Cleveland's gotten the three ball working for them in the second half. They hit three out of three shots from long range. And here's James outside. And another three for Cleveland.
Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe for success.
Knocks down the three ball. Bogdanovich has got it all tied up now for Indiana.
Oh, even from way downtown, Bogdanovich maintains that steady delivery.
Love kicks to Clarkson for three. That's in there. Love with the assist. Love's got his fourth assist in this one.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball move.
A three-pointer is right on target. A little over 2.5 minutes off the clock in this final half of play. Here's Clarkson. And another three for Cleveland.
And certainly, they are not hesitating, letting it fly from deep here in the second half.
Booker with no one around, and Indiana, another three.
And that's how you answer back.
Well, you can tell. That was a little give good, get good. Executed well on the offensive end, connects on the deep threat.
Guys, we're not going to call timeout.
And here is James.
Oh, he missed it, guys.
It's a tie game here in Cleveland. And after a quick break, we're going to come right back with the start of the fourth quarter.
So one of the Cavaliers players are going to try to score to win it at this last quarter. We're so close to getting it. Guys, we're just gonna keep on scoring.
Now Calderon, and a look at the five for the Pacers to start the fourth quarter. We've got Bojan Bogdanovic,
Sabonis,
and Stevenson, and Joseph in at the one spot. Here's Sabonis, and again it's the Pacers from deep.
Nice stroke from long range, and if he keeps getting those opportunities, he better take them.
Nice, some great passing from him.
Everybody's touching it, and you're starting to see the assists pile up because the rhythm is on display offensively.
And Indiana shooting impressively throughout at 62%. A nice shot by Booker.
Well, how about the court awareness from Bogdanovich showing off his ability to find the open man, Kev?
And the nice replay of the long-range three-pointer courtesy of Under Armour. The Unleash Chaos moment. And it goes out of bounds. That one off Joseph. Miles Turner is checked in for the Pacers. Young comes in for Trevor Booker. 1 minute now into this fourth quarter. Calderon, that's good.
An example of Calderon not letting the defensive pressure affect him once he decided to let it go.
Offensive rebound. They get a hand on it. Stevenson doesn't get the full court heave to fall.
That was what we call a brain fart. Not sure what was on his mind with that one.
That's inexcusable. That kind of shot selection isn't doing anybody any good.
Nance with no one around. That one, no good. And Indiana will come the other way. Out of bounds, Cleveland takes possession. Good substitution here for Cleveland. Love check in for Tristan Thompson. James comes in for Larry Nance. Kyle Korver.
Here we go, guys. That's what the lineup we need in the game.
In for Jose Calderon. Victor Oladipo.
He's drawn for the lead.
Allison
yes.
Comes in for Joseph. Hits it from 3-point range.
Oh, LeBron wants to take these shots when the pressure is at its highest. He does not shy away from making the play his team needs.
He muscles it in through the contact, and they call the foul. He's on his way to the free throw line.
No, oh, Kevin, he doesn't shy away from the moment. Thaddeus Young, big time delivery.
For Cleveland, they've gone 3-5 here in the fourth quarter. Pretty good numbers coming out of the break. Clarkson against Collison. Now, here's Clarkson. Shot clock at 5. From deep 3-point range, Bogdanović grabs the miss.
They're going to be tops, I think, when it's okay to take a shot like that, but not on that possession.
Oh, I mean, he can make that, but that particular distance is not his specialty.
Nice work to get it inside and draw the contact.
He doesn't hit the first, and that was the one they really won. He's got one more, though. Hill, he's checked in for the Cavaliers. So neither attempt will fall that time for him. The critical possession right here.
Crowd on pins and needles, Kev.
7-second difference, shot and game clock. And that one goes out of bounds. First touch by Oladipo.
Guys. All we need to do is make sure that LeBron has the inbound in the game.
Back to Love. Here's Smith. On the shot clock. Three-pointer. Right between the eyes.
Guys, I did not mean to do that. I didn't mean to do that. Now I need to score for the Pacers.
Just 4 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. What's your take, guys?
And with this much time, they should be able to draw the play and get themselves.
Guys, it's probably going to be OT.
Displayed there. This guy's a clutch shooter who loves being the man when the spotlight's on.
Three from the inbound, right between the eyes.
Oladipo growing into that clutch player everyone believed he could be. What great boys down the stretch.
Timeout call for Cavaliers. Guys, what do you think?
Guys, so Indiana Pacers are up by 3. Now we need to score. Now I need to score the game winner.
Goal!
We have a game winner! We just won the game! Three, guys, that's a win.
The game already won. Now they've got their fingers crossed.
And to me, guys, it looks pretty clear on the instant replay. I mean, the ball was out of his hands in time. I think they'll confirm this one pretty quickly.
And they're going to count it after looking at the replay.
Cavs won.
He got the shot off in time.
Cavs won. Bye, guys.